Well, that cooperation goes way beyond flexible funding, of course, but flexible funding is certainly a key element of that. We decided back in 2010 to stop all our earmarked funding to FAO, not only to FAO, to a whole bunch of agencies and funds and programs. And we converted all of them. It was not a savings operation. We converted all of it, dollar for dollar or euro for euro, into either complete core or flexible funding. And where we chose for flexible funding, which is a bit less than core, it was because the core formula was not available. Had the core formula, the full core formula, been available, we would certainly have gone for that. And so that was a very deliberate choice on the part of the Belgian government to really allow an organization like FAO to make best use of donor subsidies, and to get the best results for the at the lowest transfer cost. Not only did we convert this all into core or flexible funds, but we also signed multi-year agreements and therefore became, well, perhaps a mid-sized donor, smaller than the top donors, but certainly a very predictable donor over the time of the framework agreement. And in our case, the framework agreements have a four-year period. So that from a planning perspective is probably a very interesting modality as well. And of course, there is a flip side to all of that. This is not just a blank check to an organization. These are decisions made in the context of a long-standing relationship with mutual trust and appreciation of each other's added value. But from time to time, we also want to sit down and go a bit through, well, I'm not going to say through the books, that's not the point, but have an overview of the results. And that's very much what we are doing here today as part of what we call our bilateral consultations. So periodic meetings, in this case, the last one was 2 years ago, to really have an in-depth discussion of how FAO has delivered on its mandate, including through our contributions. And I must say that conversations are still ongoing, but that so far this has been a very productive exchange, including now the conversation I just had with the Director General, and very happy to see that in many areas we still have a very strong alignment of our priorities, both strategic priorities but also geographic priorities. And so flexible funds are obviously a very important piece of that, that whole equation that I just tried to describe. Well, that's basically the ones that go through to your core mandate, food security, the central place of the farmer in all of that, the importance of gender mainstreaming in that whole mandate. So those are all areas that are very important for us: value chains, productive agriculture markets. So that in terms of strategic priorities, in terms of geographic priorities, Belgian development cooperation is very focused on least developed countries, and within that group, well, today almost exclusively on sub-Saharan Africa. And so going through the results this morning and the programming of FAO, we both understood that also on a geographic basis we have almost full full overlap. And so that's a very good point of departure for the next 2 years to come, until we will meet again, but then in Brussels.